guys, it's Rachel and welcome back to my channel. And today we're going to be doing some more Valentine's Day desserts, or as is the theme on my channel, Valentine's Day desserts. A bunch of you guys pointed out in my last video that that says Valentine's Day or Valentine's Day, depending on if you prefer to park your cars yourself or have other people park them for you. I make the best jokes, you guys. Anyways though, it says Valentine's Day, not because I ran out of space, although I did run out of space, but mostly because I actually just misspelled it. It's because I don't have my letter like sorted out and alphabetized. I just kind of like grab what I needed as I'm spelling out the word, but then sometimes the spelling part doesn't happen. But my misspellings aside, we are gonna make a super cute little Valentine's Day cheesecake today. I guess it's not little, it's like a full-size cheesecake, but it is super cute. And we're gonna do a cool technique where we decorate the cheesecake itself, so we're not using any icings or anything like that. We're putting the design directly on the cheesecake, and it's super easy to do. But before we get started, if you are not subscribed already, then make sure to hit that button for lots more cute recipes and some DIYs too. And without further ado, let's get started. First of all, let's make the graham cracker crust. You're gonna need about 16 graham crackers here, 16 meaning like a full sheet of graham cracker, although you will wanna measure it just to be safe. But this is super easy. I'm just gonna pop this in a food processor just to get a nice fine crust. Then we're going to pour in one stick of melted butter. I know it seems like kind of a lot of melted butter, but it really makes that crust stay together super well, especially since we're going to be pushing the crust up the sides of the pan too. Next, throw in a quarter teaspoon of cinnamon, and then pulse that until it comes together. It should be kind of like a wet sand consistency, and it'll pack really nicely in your hands. Now we're just going to pour this into our cheesecake pan. I recommend using a 9-inch springform pan. The springform is definitely a must. If you try to use like a 9-inch regular pan, you'll have to flip the cheesecake over upside down, and that is not gonna go over so well, so I definitely recommend the springform. And like I mentioned earlier, you'll want to press that up the sides of the pan as well, and that's actually going to prevent the cheesecake from cracking. That's because the cheesecake tends to crack when it's cooling and it pulls away from the sides of the pan, but if you've got the crust there, it's going to act as a barrier so the cheesecake doesn't have to pull away on its own. Then you'll want to bake that off at 300 degrees for about 12 to 15 minutes, just until it gets nice and firm so that crust can set up a little bit. Moving on to our cheesecake mixture, you'll just want to add 3 blocks of room temperature cream cheese to a stand mixer, and just blend that through until it gets nice and smooth. You can use a hand mixer for this, but just a warning, your arms are going to get real tired because cream cheese is some thick stuff, but maybe you're stronger than me. Now we're just going to add in a cup of white sugar, and then mix that through until it is well combined. Then we're going to gradually add in 3 eggs, and these should be room temperature of course, just so everything gets nice and smooth. Then pour in a cup of sour cream and mix that through as well. To finish it off, throw in a teaspoon of vanilla extract just for that nice vanilla flavor. And now we can color our mixture. To start off, I'm gonna grab about a third cup of this and I'm going to color this red just with some red gel food color. You can really do whatever design you'd like to here, but for the design that I'm gonna make today, you're going to need red, black, pink, and a little bit of white as well. Now you can just fill your cool cheesecake crust with the remaining cheesecake batter. And then use an offset spatula just to get that nice and smooth. Perfect! I just wanted to add that face. Now we're just going to grab our pink cheesecake batter, and I'm just going to pipe on a scalloped border here. Something I noticed when I was testing this out is that you'll want to pipe a pretty thin layer of your decorating batter. If you make this layer really thick, it's going to spread out while it bakes, so the design won't be as true as to what you've originally piped out. So for instance, here with this heart, you can see I'm piping this out super thin, and that way the design isn't going to spread too much. So once I've piped out the heart, I'm just gonna go back and fill this in. And you can probably tell here, this recipe is super up to interpretation. You can really do whatever decorations you'd like to. I even tried doing some lettering with this and piping out the word love. That worked out really well too. So feel free to go as intricate as you'd like to. As long as you keep it thin, the design should stay true to what you've piped. And to finish off my own design here, I just added on a little happy face to the heart, just because I'm a cheesy person like that. And then I had a little bit of extra batter, so I decided to outline the heart as well, and that was the finishing touch for my cheesecake. To bake off our cheesecake, we're going to be using a water bath. I know it sounds like a party, but it's kind of not. You're just gonna grab 2 sheets of aluminum foil and then place them inside of a large pan that fits your cheesecake. Then place your cheesecake in the center of the foil. and we're going to use that foil to prevent any water from getting into the cheesecake pan. Now at this point, I would bring this pan up to your oven and place it in, and then pour in the water, just because the pan is way too heavy otherwise to bring into the oven. But then since I had to bring this pan upstairs and I couldn't show you guys the oven and everything, I just pretended like I was pouring the water in, which looks super dumb, but it's cool. And then you're gonna bake that off at 300 degrees for 70 to 90 minutes. I know it definitely takes a long time, but if you bake it nice and low and slow, it'll help prevent the cheesecake from cracking. Once the cheesecake comes out of the oven, let it cool slightly, maybe about 20 minutes, and then place it in the fridge for 4 hours to firm up. Then go ahead and remove the springform pan, transfer to a serving plate with a thin spatula, and then just cut yourself a slice and enjoy. This cheesecake is so good, you guys. Super rich and creamy and fluffy, and that graham cracker crust goes amazing with this. So I really hope you guys give this recipe a try. Alright guys, our cheesecake is finished now and I think it looks super cute. Like I said, this is the perfect dessert for Valentine's Day because it's totally customizable. Or you could just do a giant heart like I did and it looks super happy and cute for Valentine's Day. Anyways though, I hope you guys have enjoyed this recipe. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already for lots more recipes and DIYs. You can also follow me on social media at Kawaii Sweet Eats, and then check out my website over at kawaiisweetworld.com for the full recipe, and I will see you guys all very soon. Bye guys!